First of all, we wanted to know your views on continuous comprehensive education. What are its implications?
I think continuous and comprehensive evaluation, the whole scheme that CBSE has come out with, is a unique concept, and it's a step forward in improving our education system. And I think it encompasses a very wide range of topics in education. So it's not just about assessment or evaluation. It's probably, I mean, in principle, it's about changing the whole system of education. So I think there are many reactions to CCE all over whatever I've experienced. There are all sorts of reactions. You have people who are happy about it. You have people who don't understand it. There is a lot of confusion as to how to go about it. For many people, it's actually something that has come from the top. It's been thrust upon them, so they don't have any choice. And they have to go with it no matter what. Now, I mean, being in that situation, as I said, there are people who are confused, who find that it's a good concept and we should take it further. People feel that there are some adjustments that need to be made. So on the whole, yeah, it's a confused state of affairs right now, because not many people are also aware of what is really needed. So as one colleague of mine puts it, she calls it child-centered education instead of continuous and comprehensive evaluation, because the focus is changing from knowledge transfer or from examination to actually the child and enabling the child to learn. Now you have to focus not just on particular subjects, but you also want to, I mean, the whole idea of evaluating children on their life skills or other such scholastic areas is that you give them importance, that they matter. So, I mean, you really have to change your whole style of education. It's a big change, and I think it will be a gradual process how it gets implemented in the classroom and for it to be really understood in detail by every teacher in every class in every school. So, I think part of the task of CCE is to assess or evaluate students continuously, especially in all these areas. So in the scholastic areas, you need to test them. You have multiple choice questions, you have frequent class tests, and you're constantly evaluating and getting feedback so you can adjust your teaching according to the needs of the class. And then you have the summative tests at the end of the terms. And the solution that we've come out with is called Dashboard. And that really aids in this kind of assessment. It reduces the burden of the teacher in setting tests frequently, multiple choice questions. Multiple choice questions, if you look at it, it's actually, they're like one mark questions or very small questions. But setting each and every question requires giving it thought. It really takes time on the part of the teacher. Whether you're setting a 10 mark question or whether you're setting a one mark question, the time a teacher will need will probably remain the same. So if you have to do that frequently, then you're doing a lot of work. And plus, if you have to do the evaluation, the checking by hand and paper, it'll take time, and the teacher really won't have a lot of time to focus on other creative things in the classroom. And so this product Dashboard is basically computer-based testing within the school. A lot of the things that we've seen so far are some practice tests that students do at home to learn. But this is something within the school that is part of their formal assessment that count in the final grades a student gets at the end of the year, at the end of the term. And also it helps with the record keeping. So it not just does the assessment, it also maintains the records. You have to keep records of so many parameters in the CCE framework. It helps in that, collate everything, put it all together. And it goes a step beyond. It even helps teachers in identifying weak areas of each student, weak areas of the class as a whole. You have these learning areas called knowledge, understanding, application, skill. So questions are classified according to those. So you can, at the end of the test, the student, even the parent, reports are sent to the parent for every test also. So students, parents and teachers, everybody knows that, okay, these are the weak areas, these are the strong areas, these are where we need to work on. So it helps identify weak areas. Questions are also categorized as easy, average, difficult, and you get much more information as to how the class is doing. Yeah, it has been deployed in some schools and they have positive feedback for it. Yeah.
And lastly, we wanted to know your views on RTE.
On?
Right to education.
What exactly would you like to know on RTE?
Are you happy with it? What are the complications associated with right to education?
See, in principle, right to education is a very good concept. I mean, in a country like ours where education is not easily accessible, I wouldn't say that people don't want to educate their children, but quality education is not easily available everywhere. And I think the biggest challenge of RTE will be in filling in the gaps in that. A lot of times people talk about that the poorer sections of society don't want to send their children to school, they make them child laborers, or they make them work. There is a reason behind it, because they don't have good quality schools accessible to them at the, they can't pay or whatever reason they have, or it's not available in rural areas. You see, many of the government schools, they don't have enough teachers. Even these days, even private schools are facing shortages of teachers. So that is a big gap that needs to be filled in. Plus the kind of education that goes on in these institutions leaves a lot to be desired. And students, I can share a very personal experience with you that when I was in college, I was part of this NSS thing. We had to do it compulsorily. And one of the options was to go and teach some of the kids in a village in a slum or something. So I was sitting with these class 5 students who used to go to a government school, and it was very sad to see that they're trying to learn maths, they can't understand maths or any other subject because they do not know English. They're being taught in English, but they do not know English, and they do not know English after having reached class 5. So if your medium of instruction is English, and English is being taught they're not even doing well in English as a subject, then how can they do well in another subject? So there's so many issues in improving the quality of education that will really, this is just one instance. You need to address a lot of these issues to make sure that right to education really has an effect. In principle, of course, ideally it's very good, but the devil lies in the detail and the implementation.